The other integration technique that we're going to be talking about is called trigonometric substitution. Trigonometric substitution now. So as the name suggests, in this technique, we're going to be replacing our usual variable by a trigonometric function. So this technique is going to be useful when we see something like something squared minus x squared plus something squared, or x squared minus something squared with or without the square root in our integral. So let's talk about the first one first. I mean, and I'm going to do this along together with the first example here. So let's say if I have a triangle, if I have a right triangle and I have the angle theta here, and one of the sides opposite to the angle theta is x, and then one of the sides is a, then I'm going to have that this other side is going to be the square root of a square minus x square. So it turns out that I can change my variable from this blue x here to theta. So I'm going to have that sine of theta, sine of the angle that I have here, sine of theta, is going to be just x over a. So sine of theta is going to be just x over a. And cosine of theta, cosine of theta, cosine of theta, as we can see here, is going to be the square root of a square minus x square over a. So that's going to be the square root of, let's see, a square minus x square over a. Now then, I can move this a to the other side, and I'm going to get the first equation that I'm looking at here, the square root of a square minus x square. It's going to be just a times cosine theta. So let me move this a bit. So it's going to be just a times cosine theta. Now, if I want to find the x, I can manipulate this equation a little bit. So let me go to this one because the equation for sine theta is a little easier to look at than the cosine one. I'm going to move a to the other side as well. So I'm going to have that my x is a times sine of theta. Now, if I take derivative of this guy, so I'm going to get that dx is going to be a is a constant, so that stay there, times derivative of sine become cosine. So that's going to be a times cosine of theta and d theta. So then basically, I can now use these two equations. So it's actually going to be these three equations to change my variable from x to theta. So let's kind of try that in my first, in the first example that we have down here. I'd like to integrate 1 over 1, the square root of 1 minus x squared. So here my a is going to equal to 1. So my a is going to equal to 1. So let me try to first draw the triangle. So my triangle is going to be a right triangle. The side that is opposite to the right angle is going to be a, which is 1. This other side is going to be x, so this side is going to be the square root of 1 minus x squared, and my angle theta is going to be here. So I can basically use what we have up here. I'm going to have that x is going to be, x over 1 is going to be sine theta. So let me kind of zoom in here a little bit. So sine of theta is gonna be just x over a. So which is x over a is just x. So it means because a is 1. So sine theta is gonna be just x. So that means dx is gonna be just derivative of sine is cosine. So that's gonna be cosine of theta and then d theta. And now we're gonna see that the square root of 1 minus x squared over 1. So this is gonna be cosine of theta now. So this thing is gonna be cosine of theta. So now I can go ahead and change the variable that we see in the integral here. I have that cosine of theta is just the square root of 1 minus x squared, so over 1. That doesn't do anything, so I can remove that. So the function in the integral now is going to be just 1 over cosine of theta. So this is going to be 1 over cosine of theta. And dx, I knew that dx is just cosine theta d theta. So this is going to be just cosine of theta d theta. So now what happened here is that the cosine theta get cancelled out, so these two things get cancelled out. I'm just gonna be left with 1. So this is just the integral of 1 and then d theta. So the integral of 1 is just gonna be theta plus c. So that is actually my integral here. So that's gonna give me just theta plus c. But what is theta anyway? So because my original integral is in terms of x, so I want to change my answer here back to x. So we have x equal to sine theta earlier. So I can take arcsine of both sides. So from here, I take arcsine on both sides. Arcsine and sine get cancelled out. So I'm gonna get that arcsine of x is gonna equal to theta. Or you can see that arcsine is the inverse function of sine. So if I move sine to the other side, I'm gonna get arcsine. So I get that theta is gonna be just arcsine of x, and I can take the substitute, replace this back, so this is just going to equal to arcsine of x plus c. So here is my answer for part A. The key thing is kind of what we see here. Whenever I see dx, I can replace that with cosine theta d theta, and that's what we did here. So whenever I see dx, I can replace that with cosine theta d theta. And whenever I see the square root of 1 minus x squared, I can replace that with cosine theta. And that's kind of what happened here. Whenever we see x, we can also replace that with sine of theta, but we don't have to do that here. So I didn't have to use this pink substitution. So this is the first form of the trigonometric substitution, by the way. So there are two other forms. So let me talk about the next one right now. So the next one, for the first one, this is useful when we have things like the square root of something square minus x square. The second form is going to be useful when we have things like the square root of x square plus something square. In this case, I can now construct a triangle. So if I construct a triangle, a right triangle, by the way, so one of the angles here is going to be theta. And I want tan theta to be x over a, so the side length here is going to be x, the length here is going to be a. So this side is going to be the square root of x squared plus a squared. And as we can see, we're going to have that tan theta is x over a, so I have the first thing to begin with. So x over a is going to just equal to tan of theta. So now, I can write the secant of x or sec of theta. My sec of theta, my secant of theta is going to be, well, secant is this side over this side. So that's going to be the square root of x squared plus a squared over a. So secant of theta is going to be this thing over a. Now I can move a to the other side, so I'm gonna have that the square root of x squared plus a squared is gonna be a times secant of theta. So this is the first equation on the line that we see here. So we can use this to substitute the square root of x squared plus a squared by a times secant of theta. And now, if I want to find the x, I can use this other equation to find the x. I can move a to the other side, so I'm gonna have that x is equal to a times tan of theta. If I take the derivative on both sides, I'm gonna have that dx is gonna equal to just, a is constant, so that stay there. The derivative of tan is actually gonna be secant squared, so it's gonna be secant squared of theta times d theta, times d theta. So once again, whenever I see x squared plus a squared, I can replace that by a times secant of theta. Whenever I see dx, I can replace that by a times secant squared times d theta. And whenever we see x over a, or whenever we see x, we can replace that with tan of theta. So let me try this in the other example here. So let's take a look at part B. I have 1 over x squared plus 4. Notice how we actually did not have the square root here. I only have the x squared plus 4. But for this function, we can use the usual technique that we have seen earlier. For example, if I want to find the u substitution, so if I try letting u equal to the denominator here, x squared plus 4, then I'm going to have that du is 2x dx. But I didn't see 2x anywhere, so u sub is not useful. If I try the integral by parts, so I'm going to have u dv. So once again, I did not see anything useful that I can be used, that can be used as u and v here. And if I try the integral by partial fractions, I have to factor the denominator here, and it turns out that x squared plus 4, we can factor this f over the real, but I can kind of write this as, let me see, I can write this as x minus 2i and x plus 2i. Notice how if I have the 2i squared, that's going to be 4 times I squared, so that's going to be 4 times negative 1. So this is the factor of x squared plus 4 over the complex number. But whenever we have complex number, things can get really weird, so let's try not to do this. So let's actually use the trigonometric substitution that we have seen. So what we're going to do is, once again, I'm going to draw a triangle here. This is x squared plus 4 squared. It's in the form of x squared plus something squared. So it's going to be in the second form here. I'm going to let my triangle look like this, where tan theta is x over a. Here, my a is going to equal to 2. So my a is going to equal to 2. And my triangle is going to look like this. So I'm gonna want my x to be here, my a, which is 2, to be here. And this side is gonna be the square root of x squared minus 4. And I'm gonna have that tan of theta. I'm gonna have that tan of theta, which is the little angle here. Tan of theta is gonna be x over 2. Now, I can also have x squared, the square root of x squared plus 4 over 2. Let me kind of write that over here. The square root of x squared plus 4 over 2. That's going to equal to secant of theta. So that's going to equal to secant of theta. Now let me move to the other side here. So I'm going to have that the square root of x squared plus 4 is just 2 times secant of theta. 2 times secant of theta. And from the first equation that we see earlier, if I move 2 to the other side, I'm going to have that x is 2 times tan of theta. If I take the derivative of this thing, then I'm going to get that dx is going to be just 2 times the derivative of tan is secant squared. So this is 2 times secant squared of theta and then d theta. This is the two equations that we see earlier, by the way. So that means whenever we see x squared plus 4 in the square root, I can replace that by 2 times secant of theta. And whenever I see the x, I can replace that by 2 times secant of theta squared, d theta. And that's kind of what we see in this integral here. I have x squared plus 4 down here, and I have dx here. So if I were to rewrite this integral, that's going to be the integral of this thing squared. So that's going to be 1 over 2 squared is 4, and then that I'm going to get secant squared of theta times dx. And my dx, I knew that's going to be just 2 secant squared d theta. So this is going to be 2 times secant squared theta and then d theta. So here I replace the blue part by this blue part here, and I replace the green part by the little green part here. Notice how now my secant squared actually get cancelled out. So the secant squared get cancelled out to cancel out with the 4, so I'm going to be left with only 1/2. So it's going to be the integral of 1/2 d theta. So the integral of 1 half d theta is gonna be just 1 half theta plus c. So I have 1 half theta plus c. So once again, this is not my final answer yet because I have to change everything back to x. Now, so let me go back to my original equation here. So I have that x is 2 times tan theta. So if I move, so let me see, okay, this is fine. So let me actually move 2 back to the other side. So it's actually going to be back to the other equation here. So it's going to be x over 2 is tan of theta. Now then, I can take arctan on both sides, or I can move tan from this side to arctan to the other side. I'm gonna get that theta here is just gonna equal to arctan of x over 2. Arctan of x over 2. So then I can substitute this into the theta that we see here. So my final answer is gonna be just 1 half times arctan of x over 2. And the whole thing plus c. And so here is my answer for part B. For part C, I have 1 over x squared times the square root of x squared plus 4. Once again, this is in the form the square root of x squared plus something squared. So this is in the second form that we see here. So that means whenever we see the square root of x squared plus a squared, I can replace that. I can make substitute by a times secant of theta, and I can replace dx by a times secant of theta squared d theta. This is, this is actually the same thing that we did in the previous part. So let me actually use the same substitution here because my a here is just gonna be 2 again. So let me do the substitution. Whenever I see the square root of x squared plus 4, whenever I see the blue thing here, I can replace that by 2 times secant of theta, and my dx, my green thing, I can replace that by 2 times secant square of theta d theta. So, if I make the substitution, I'm gonna have the integral of 1 over x square, and then the blue part, which is 2 times secant of theta, 2 times secant of theta. And my dx here is gonna be just 2 times secant squared, 2 times secant squared times d theta. So let's see, the secant get cancelled out, so I'm gonna be left with just the secant in the numerator, and then the 2 also get cancelled out. So my integral now becomes the integral of secant of theta over x squared, and then d theta, Notice how I actually cannot integrate this yet because, let me kind of draw the line here. Notice how I can't actually integrate this yet because now I have 2 variables. I have theta and I have x, and I want to replace x by theta. So let me try another substitution here. Notice how we say earlier that I can replace x by 2 times tan of theta. So I can change the variable here again. So my x is gonna be just 2 times tan of theta. So I replace everything to theta. So this is gonna be the integral of secant of theta over x squared, which is 2 times tangent squared. And the whole thing, d theta. So now I have changed my variable to theta completely. Let me try to simplify this thing. I will have, two squared is 4, and 1/4 is just a number, so I can pull out of the integral. So I'm gonna have 1/4 out here, and secant is just 1 over cosine, so let me actually write 1 over cosine of theta here. And tangent is sine over cosine. I have tangent squared. So I'm gonna have sine square over cosine square in the denominator, so I can bring the cosine square up to the numerator, so I'm gonna have cosine square of theta, this thing over sine square of theta, sine square of theta, and the whole thing d theta here. Now then, the cosine get cancelled out, so I'm gonna be left with only just a cosine in the numerator now. Now my integral become the 1/4, the integral of, let me see, cosine of theta over sine square d theta over sine square, and then d theta here. This look like something we can integrate using the u substitution. So I'm gonna let my u be the sine theta here. So my u is gonna be sine theta. My du is then gonna become derivative of sine is just a cosine. So it's just gonna be cosine theta d theta, which is kind of what we see up here. So now I can make the u substitution. My integral now will become 1/4. The integral of cosine theta d theta is just du. So this is gonna be du over sine, which is u square. So now this is just 1/4, the integral of 1 over u square du, and 1 over u square, this is just u to the negative 2, so let me replace that, u to the negative 2. I can integrate this thing, that's gonna give me 1/4 u to the negative 1 over negative 1. Now then u to the, plus, and also plus c. U to the negative 1 is 1 over u, so this thing is gonna equal to negative 1 over 4u, and then plus c. Now, this is not my final answer yet, because I want to get my answer in x. So let me try to change the variable back, Now, my u is sine of theta, so let me replace that here. So this thing is gonna equal to negative 1 over 4. My u, once again, is sine of theta plus c. Now, what is sine of theta? If you look at the triangle that we have here, we can see that sine of theta, by the way, part c and part b, we use the same picture because it's the same thing, x squared plus 4 squared. If I look at my triangle here, sine of theta is gonna be x over the square root of x squared plus 4, so I can substitute this for sine of theta in my answer here. So, in the end, what I'm gonna get is that this is gonna equal to negative 1 over 4 times, I forget what I want to write again. So it's gonna be sine of theta is gonna be x over the square root of x squared plus 4, and then plus c. Now I can bring the square root thing here up to the numerator, so my final answer for this problem is gonna be negative the square root of x squared plus 4 over 4x, and then the whole thing plus c. So in a nutshell, here's how we do the last example that we have here. So this is the trigonometric substitution. Then it's going to be useful when we see something like x squared plus or minus something squared, maybe with or without the square root. Now let me actually go back and talk about the last form as well. So we talk about the first two forms, which we can use when we see the square root of something squared minus x squared plus something squared. Now the last form is going to be useful when we see something of the form the square root of x squared minus something squared in this last form. So let me once again draw my rectangle, my triangle. I would like to have the secant of theta to be x over a now. So if my theta is here and I want secant of theta to be x over a, so my x is gonna be over here and my a is gonna be over here. So the length of this side is gonna be x squared minus the square root of x squared minus a squared. And I'm gonna have that the secant of theta the secant of theta is going to be x over a, just like what I want. And I'm also going to have that the tangent of this angle here, the tangent of theta. Is going to equal to the square root of x squared minus a squared divided by a. So it's going to be the square root of x squared minus a squared divided by a. And I can move a to the other side, and I'm going to get that the square root of x squared minus a squared equal to a times tan of theta. And I can take the derivative of the first equation that we have earlier. I can move a to the other side, so I'm going to have that x is going to equal to a times secant of theta. Once I take the derivative of this thing, I'm going to have that dx is going to equal to, let me see, a is a constant, so that stay there. The derivative of secant is actually going to be secant times tangent. So it's going to be secant of theta times tangent of theta, and then times d theta. So that means in the last form, whenever we see something like the square root of x squared minus a squared, I can replace that by a times tan theta. So I can change my variable from x to theta. And whenever we see dx, I can replace that with a times secant of theta times tan of theta d theta. By the way, I think I forget to put d theta here, so that should be here. Okay, so here is the integration by trigonometric substitution. This is the last this is the last integration technique that we're gonna talk about, by the way. So in the next lecture, we're gonna change the topic completely and talk about sequence and series now.